Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome to another episode of Be Creative, Be Great. I want to thank everybody for tuning into the channel. I want to thank all those subscribers that have been subscribing to my channel as well and show the support, comment, and all that stuff that are following me on my Instagram and my social media pages and stuff. I want to thank you guys for always showing that support. I appreciate it. I haven't done as many videos as I want. You know, it's been a lot going on. But I wanted to touch something tonight that I felt was very important, and it's something that I believe in, and I was hoping that I can use my channel to reach a broader audience and send this message to a lot more people than just my region where I'm at in Connecticut. So as you know, we're dealing with a crisis right now. We're dealing with something that no one ever thought, you know, was going to come. And, you know, we have to be prepared, right? We always have to be ready, and we always have to be prepared in the good times and in the bad times. And I wanted to share a message of hope. I wanted to share a message of strength, and I wanted to share a message of prayer, right? We're in a country, the United States has been a country that has, you know, been founded on faith and on prayer. And, you know, just to touch a little bit, right? The Bible is still the number one selling book out there, yet it's the least book that we practice, right? There's so many fundamentals and so many teachings in there that we can apply in our daily lives if we just read it and ask God to illuminate our minds and give us understanding for it. But I want to take this time to connect with me. How about that, right? I want you guys to connect with me in prayer, right? In the midst of this crisis that we're going through right now, which has been affecting everybody, right? It's affecting everyone. It's almost worldwide. And in the midst of this crisis, I want all of us not to get into the mode of fear, right? The Bible tells me that I shouldn't, you know, I shouldn't be fearful. The Bible says, you know, I didn't give you, God never told us that he gave us a spirit of fear, but he gave us a spirit of power, right? That's in the book of 2 Timothy, when Paul is talking to Timothy in there, right? And we also have in the book of Philippians, which I wanted to share with you guys too, in Philippians chapter 4, right? This is all biblical. This is not something me coming out. This is just biblical things that I'm practicing right now. And in the book of Philippians chapter 4, it says, don't worry about anything, but in everything through prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus, right? This is something that I'm trying to practice in the midst of this crisis. And I was hoping that through this channel, through this video, I can reach more people to connect with me in a prayer, as the scripture says. You know, in the midst of this situation where it says, don't worry about anything, but in everything in prayer, I think this is a moment where we need to present this in prayer. And, you know, there's certain things that we can control physically, and then there's these other things that we can't. I don't want you to see this video and get the wrong perspective from it, but you know, we're still following the normal principles, right? There's policies in place of putting gloves and masks and all these things during this crisis. I'm not saying to stop those things, because if the president is putting these things into place, it's because, you know, they're seeing something, you know, greater that we can't see as the people for now, you know. But if he's putting these measures in place, it's because he wants to keep us safe. You know, I truly believe that. But that's not the whole point here. The whole point here is that we can come together in a prayer to lift up, you know, the name of God, to lift Christ's name on high in the midst of this moment. You know, that we can pray and ask God to help us get through this, that we can ask God to give us understanding and wisdom to understand what is going on in the midst of this crisis, not be fearful and not hide in our homes, and, you know, like, just be stuck in a place where we're like hopeless. And this video, I'm hoping that I can give you hope and give you some type of strength and courage that, you know what, I understand there's a lot of things going on, but let's pray about this. How about we do come together? How about we come together in a prayer and just ask God to intervene? Ask God to illuminate our minds, to show us what exactly he's doing in the midst of this. Because I do know that even in the midst of this, I know God is still moving. I know God is still talking. And I know God is still trying to guide us and lead us. He just needs his people to listen. And I think that's very important at this moment. And I'm hoping that through this video, I can connect with other people to share this video and start a prayer that we want to initiate through this channel, you know, through the team of Be Creative, Be Great. I would love to initiate a prayer for 3 days, starting tomorrow from the 22nd to the 24th. If we can just present, you know, our lives before God in this crisis, and we ask God to make a change, you know, make a change. Tomorrow, I believe, at the White House, you know, there's going to be a prayer going on at the White House, and it'll be awesome for us to connect as well with the White House and what the president is doing for the country as far as prayer. And I wanted to share this video because not only did I wanted to share these two passages with you, but I wanted to open up a prayer for the 22nd to the 24th that we can just come together and just ask God to have his way, man. Ask God to speak to us, individually, and to speak to us as a country, to let us know, you know, what exactly is going on and what we need to do to get through this. I definitely know God is not, you know, he's not instilling in us fear. That's not what he wants. But he wants to instill in us a courage and boldness that in him we can do all things, and that through prayer we can bring forth change. So, you know, I wanted to make this video short and concise, and I hope it reaches a broader audience. So if you can, please help me share this video and share it to as many people as you can tonight and starting tomorrow when this prayer is being lifted up. And listen, if you're at your home, you're at your office, because there's certain companies that can still go into the office as long as they're meeting the specific guidelines. But listen, let's just come together in prayer, right? You know, it's not about, at this moment, it's not about looking at our president and judging him and looking at all these other things and trying to like justify certain things. Now is not the time for that. I think now is the time for us to come together like never before. You know, it's not time to point the finger at people here and there, who's doing it wrong, or, you know, who's doing it right, and you know, and get upset and aggravated and all this stuff. I want to share this video to bring peace and just to take it easy. And let's just come together, man. Let's just come together. There's certain things that are out of our hands, and through prayer, I think we can do a lot of change through it. So I want to open up this channel right now, and I want you, those who are subscribed to my channel, if you can connect with me, man, and connect with everyone else who's gonna be joining in this prayer. I've also, you know, spoken to my church, and we're also actively involved in a prayer. Our services are being live streamed, and I know a ton of other churches are doing the same thing and spreading the message through technology, which is an amazing thing. And I just wanted to use this outlet to do the same thing, man. Let's pray. Let's come together in prayer. So please share this video. It's going to be uploaded on my channel, is going to be uploaded on Facebook. You're going to be able to see it on my Instagram channel, also becreative_BGR8. And all these things are going to be linked in my bio, as well as other links there that are pretty useful and can edify you right now at this moment. I think what we really need to do during these times is come in prayer, and come in prayer as a body, as a whole, everyone. If we can reach the world, and if we can have them connect in this prayer for the next 3 days, I believe and I know that God will do an amazing thing, and that God will speak to you in an amazing way and give you some illumination and open up, your eyes to see what exactly is really happening. So I just wanted to initiate it by starting a quick prayer. So Heavenly Father, I come before your presence. I thank you, God, for this moment, this opportunity that you have given me, Lord Father God, and this YouTube outlet, Lord Father God, to reach a broader audience. I ask you at this moment, Lord Jesus, that you illuminate our minds, illuminate my mind, Lord Father God, to understand really what's going on in this during these times that we're dealing with right now, Lord God. I know there's a ton of people, Lord God, with questions, Lord God, with a lot of doubt, Lord Jesus. But I know, Lord Father God, that if we lift up a prayer, you will begin to answer those questions, that you will begin to give light to those doubts that people have, God. I trust in you, Lord, and I just want to apply, Lord Father God, what your word says, Lord Father God, because your word is life, and your word has been telling me today, Lord Father God, let us trust in you and let us, you know, present to you things through prayer, Lord God. So I'm asking you, Lord God, right now, Lord, that you help us, God, that you help our country, that you help this world, Lord Father God. You know, guide us, Lord Jesus, so we can move the way you want us to move, Heavenly Father. And I even pray right now for our President Donald Trump, Lord God, and his whole team, Lord God. I pray, Lord Jesus, that your illumination may shine upon his mind as well, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you may also guide him as a president, Lord Father God, that you have appointed for this time, Lord Jesus. I pray that you give him strength, wisdom and understanding, Lord Father God, to make the right decisions, Lord. I pray that his team, Lord God, may also be in the same spirit, Lord Father God. I pray, Lord Father God, that our country, Lord Jesus, may come together in prayer, Lord Jesus, to believe in you, because I know our country has been founded in prayer, Lord. And I just ask you, Lord God, at this moment, Jesus, I don't know all the answers, God. I don't know all the answers. I do things wrong at times, Lord Father God, like we all do, Lord. But I do trust in you, and I do know that you are the higher power, Lord God. So I present to you this COVID crisis that we're dealing with right now, Lord God. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that you pour peace upon our lives, Lord God, that we may trust and believe in you in the midst of this, Lord God. So in the midst of this COVID-19, I choose to pray. I choose to call on you, Lord God. And I'm opening up this outlet. Who are you going to choose to call right now in the midst of this crisis? I pray that you choose Christ. I pray that you choose prayer at this moment. Heavenly Father, I just thank you, God. I thank you in the midst of this time, Lord. I thank you for my home. I thank you for my family. I thank you for my brothers and sisters, Lord. I thank you for the job that I have, Lord Jesus. I thank you for the things, Lord God, that you have provided until now, Lord Jesus. And I know that you will continue to provide, Lord. Give us peace, Lord God. But I thank you, Lord God, even in the midst of this, Lord, because I know that you're moving and that you're still talking, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I pray. Amen. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this encourages you tonight. And you got questions, please comment, put some comments on the video, you know, DM me with any messages, you know, if you have specific petitions that you want to pray for, or, you know, certain things you want to pray about, please let me know in the comments, send me a message, and we'll also present, you know, in our church that we can also lift these things in prayer, man. Let's do God together, you know, and I believe that we can make a major change through it. God bless you. God bless America. And I just pray that after you see this video, that you may be, you know, led by the Spirit to hit that share button, and that we can reach a broader audience through these next couple of days, that we could come into prayer and make a major impact. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Hit the alert button so you can stay updated with new videos that I'll be posting out there. But until next time, man, never settle with being good when you've been meant to be great. Later.